favorite season ever. So it's more rewarding than ever to hear the response. You know, when we did the first episode, and we went some of the black and white, you know, and the original idea was we had these two parallel timelines. We were trying to figure out, like, how do we tell the audience immediately that we're in a different timeline? And the first thing I did was I played with just desaturating the flashbacks and then oversaturating the present day stuff. And just I did a little test in the Avid when we were cutting the episode, and it looked like watching The Wizard of Oz. Like, everything is so green that everything looked like, so like the zombies all of a sudden didn't look dead anymore because we added color to their faces. So we looked at it and we're like, well, that doesn't really work because it's not, you know, Wizard of Oz. So going with the black and white was a big leap for us. And I know Scott Gimple and I were nervous about the black and white because it was so different. It had great aspects of it because it sort of harkened to the comic book, and it felt a little Night of Living Dead, George Romero-ish, so we loved that part of it. But like when you see the quarry stuff in color, and the zombies go over the edge of the quarry and hit the ground and explode in glorious color, it's awesome. So I'm hoping, and I'm thinking that in the DVD, I think we're going to do a color version. People that have seen the episode will now understand the timeline, so I think we're going to do a full color version for the DVD, and then we'll do the aired version as well. So it's been pretty, we were really ecstatic, because we were a little nervous about that. There's a zombie coming up in a future episode that in the script was called Bernie Wrightson Zombie. And anybody that knows who Bernie Wrightson is, he's a fantastic illustrator, comic book artist who's been around for decades. And he has a very specific style. So I love that they wrote in the script Bernie Wrightson Zombie, so I knew exactly what that was supposed to look like. So we ended up doing something where we were able to shrink the zombie's waist a little bit, and we removed his nose, and I think he's in the Comic-Con trailer for like a split second. But when we did it, it was like, wow, we're just continuing to sort of open up more avenues for us by not limiting what we're able to do.
I was wondering, what character do you relate to most on The Walking Dead?
Character I relate to most? You know, I would probably say Glenn, because that was not planned. Thank you for getting me in trouble. But I'm just saying, honestly, I mean, I love that character. I always thought that in the comic book he comes out with that sort of, he's got a great sort of comic sense to him, but he also has the fate of the group at heart, and he doesn't descend into madness like Rick does. So I always thought that he was probably the most solid of our core group, and I think that's probably why I relate to that character as well. I mean, everybody always says, oh, Rick, I'm like, really? You want to run around and pull guns on people and beat the crap out of everybody? So.
All right, go ahead.
Hi.
So my question is, if we know from past seasons that there are situations where, like, trimming for pets or smearing zombie guts on you, making you invisible to walkers, why are we not using that more in maybe situations where Glenn's trapped on a dumpster?
Come on,
it's so funny. I love reading. I do love reading all of the theories because they're all great. And the fact that people are talking so passionately about it is a tribute to Steven, a tribute to the writer, to Jim Fisher. But there's one thing that nobody's ever asked that I find fascinating. Why don't they just go up on the roof? When they're in the pet shop, why don't they just be like, oh, there's a big zombie horde. Let's just hang out on the roof for a couple hours. The horde will go through, and then they'll be fine. Somebody said treehouse. Somebody else was like, yeah, there's going to be a treehouse and I haven't survived. But if they would have just gone up on the roof.
But, I mean,
that's what I would, just for the record, that's why I'll be the last one alive. I'll be on the roof while you dumbass and down the roof. This way, wait, no, let's go this way.
It's got to be.
You know what, that's a great point. One of the hardest things for us is we're in it every single day. And we don't get a lot of opportunity to get feedback on the show because we start in May and then we're opportunity is either Comic-Con, where I showed the trailer, or interacting with you guys at a Walker Stalker convention. But it reinvigorates us. It's like, right when you think your tank is empty, you're like, I can't go on anymore. Just shoot me in the head. I'm not going to make it. And then people watch the episode, and then they respond to the episode, and they go, greatest season ever. I can't believe they did that. Even if you guys get angry about certain things, anger's okay, because anger means you're passionate about the show like we are. I think that reinvigorates us in terms of what we do on the show, episode after episode. And it really, so your guys' devotion to the show, your guys' loyalty to the show, makes the show better, because when you talk about how much you love it, or if you talk about how mad you are, that makes us want to make the show even better, because we know we're reaching. So that was a good observation. I didn't hear that. Next question.
Do you think Glenn is dead?
Hell no, Glenn ain't
dead.
That's
what I like to hear. Do you think Glenn is alive or dead?
I think something's up, honestly. Like, something doesn't quite seem like what we saw is exactly what's going on.
Is Glenn dead?
No.
No.
You guys think Glenn is dead?
No.
Is Glenn dead?
No.
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 You guys think Glenn is dead?
No, he is not dead.
He's alive. Glenn's alive. Do you think Glenn is dead?
You know, I'm